others in solar, but for TOPCon they really played a special role, because everyone who's working on passivated technology or passivated contacts actually leaned the name from the technology that was developed at Fraunhofer ESIS. So we are happy to have with us Jochen Rentsch, who's head of department production technologies at Fraunhofer ESIS, where he's heading a team working in the field of production technologies for crystalline silicon solar cells with special focus on wet and plasma technology, as well as passivated industrial solar cell structures. Jochen has supervised numerous PhD and master theses and over 80 publications in the field of crystalline silicon PV. We're happy to have Jochen talk about transfer of TOPCon processes to industrial PECVD tools. Jochen, welcome.
Right. Yeah. First of all, thanks for the very nice introduction. I'm also really happy to share, let's say, our results here for the industrial TOPCon solar cells with all of you, with this great audience in this also really very nice conference. So congrats first. Yes, I will, after this very nice introduction by Shunduri about, let's say, the TOPCon solar cell technology in general, I think I'm well prepared to get a little bit deeper look into one specific technology, especially to form the passivated contact at the rear side. And in this case, I will show you, let's say, results of a PECVD process, exactly doing that job. Also, let's say, the challenges which we are facing there. Right. So luckily, he was not showing, let's say, the actual rough overview of efficiencies achieved currently with industrial TOPCon. So we are not duplicating that part. So here you can see that, as it was already mentioned, there are nowadays many players active in the field of TOPCon solar cells. And there have been also already really very high efficiencies reached, especially above 24% by Trina and Jinko in a kind of a pilot line ambient. And then I think we will more or less hear a lot more in the last talk for this session. Only in the moment, only really pure and a strong TOPCon manufacturer, Jollywood, which gives in the moment, let's say, kind of an industrial benchmark for that technology with 23.5%. All of them, as it was already mentioned also by Shunduri, using LPCVD for the implementation of the polysilicon layer. And then you already see that there are, of course, also already very nice results with other technologies, with PECVD, to form the poly layer with all around 23% by Meyerburger, Ceres, etc. So the structure we have already seen. I come also back to this later on. What I will talk about here today is the implementation. So first, the transfer of these PECVD processes to an industrial PECVD furnace. And then I will talk a little bit about some parameter optimization and investigations of these PECVD layer depositions in order to optimize the efficiency of the final TOPCon cell. Right, to start with, so the TOPCon process here was mainly done on an industrial PECVD tool, Centrotherm C plasma system, I think well known in the industry for many years for silicon nitride deposition, nowadays also aluminum oxide deposition with 40 kilohertz direct plasma generation. And in the pictures, you can see also the boat, the deposition boat. I think it was the same picture like Shunduri had, I think, on one of his last slides. So actually here with such tool, all the later results, which I will present, have been performed. So what can be already proven was that you can reach an excellent passivation over the entire boat. In that case, that boat just keeps 144 wafers. You have the possibility for the in situ phosphorus doping, which I think is quite important for also a relatively lean process sequence. And you can reach high deposition rates above 10 nanometers per minute, which then also gives relatively short deposition times for the, in the moment, still relatively thick TOPCon layers, which are currently still needed for the current state of screen printing pace. Maybe that was one comment, I think, or in the discussion from the last talk. We strongly believe that, of course, once the TOPCon layers could be made much thinner, then of course you will definitely also improve, especially the bifaciality of the TOPCon solar cells. So I think we will see much improvement there also in the future. So how does this result? As you see there, the implied VOC then for different boat positions after hydrogenation reaching very nice and high level above 740 millivolts, really proving that you can have a very good passivation quality. So how far can this go? We have even reached record lifetimes with this technology, really approaching the Auger limit, as can be seen there on the right diagram. And if you put it a bit in perspective with also other reported passivation parameters, you can see there that with this technology and in the current state, we reach J naught various now close to zero, so 0.2 femtoamps per square centimeter on the planar surface, and this is really in this case exceptionally low. So very high lifetimes are possible with this technology. So now speaking a bit of the optimization needed also to integrate it in a current industrial TOPCon solar cell structure. So there are some challenges, of course, to be covered. The firing stability of the thermal oxide polysilicon stack and the contact formation. And then finally, of course, also I will show you some recent solar cell results. So here again, I promised the process flow we see here for our iTopCon approach based on this PECVD polysilicon. So after saw damage etch and texturing, we have first the boron diffusion for the front side, followed by the wet chemical etch isolation. Then we are forming the TOPCon rear side with a thermal oxide and the PECVD, poly deposition. Then we have, let's say, the aluminum oxide and nitride front side passivation of the boron emitter, the nitride coverage of the rear poly tunneling oxide poly stack, and finally the screen printed metallization of front and rear, both cases still silver, and the fast firing. So still in the moment, of course, the TOPCon layers are relatively thick with 150 nanometers. So this just as some kind of key features. So how is the passivation after firing? Here, as you can see on this kind of test structures, so on high ohmic n-type float zone silicon with a TOPCon layer, tunneling oxide plus poly layer, and the covering silicon nitride. And this after the firing at different temperatures, you can see that you can reach very low J naughts, 3 to 4 femtoamps per square centimeter on a textured surface, depending also a bit on the structure of your silicon nitride layer. So here at different refractive indexes, and of course, depending on the firing temperature, which is then later needed for the metallization. So again, here the composition, as can be seen, if you look at for between 1.9 and or roughly 1.95 and 2.05, you can see quite a drastic change in J naught. So the composition of the nitride is relatively crucial. On the other hand, of course, it's not only the passivation quality, but you also need to ensure the contact formation with the screen printing. So as was seen, the IVOC increases the IVOC decreases with the firing temperature, as it is shown here. On the other hand, of course, the contact resistance also decreases, so makes the contact better if you go to higher firing temperatures. So definitely that's a typical point to find an optimum, and the current optimum, if you target in contact resistivity of roughly 1 milliohm per square centimeter, you can reach J naught met values of 100 to 200 femtoamps per square centimeter, which would still allow, let's say, a decent fill factor with such a combination of parameters. Right, now let's say switch a bit to the front side, looking also at the boron diffusion process, which is of course also a key feature of this TOPCon hybrid cell structure. We also there investigated three different diffusion profiles, ending up in an emitter sheet resistance range between 110 and 150 ohms per square, ending up with J naught E's between roughly 15 and 30 femtoamps per square centimeter at relatively similar profiles. How they differ in the end, again, now here, the VOC shown after firing. In that case, you can see that with a higher sheet resistance, you can see actually an improvement in VOC. I mean, that's what you can, of course, also, which is relatively clear. And on the other hand, with increasing firing temperature, you can see a decrease for all the different emitter types. So again, you have to find a good compromise for the firing temperature and the emitter sheet resistance for, in the end, an optimum for an optimum passivation quality. In that case, you can reach J naught of around 45 femtoamps per square centimeter with this boron emitter on the front side, and which is now, of course, also obvious if you now compare, let's say, the passivation quality of the poly at the rear with a boron emitter passivation at the front, that the VOC, of course, of a TOPCon cell is still strongly limited by the front side. Nevertheless, as it was shown, you need higher firing temperatures to get this low contact resistance. This is a little bit in conflict, as was shown on the previous slide, with the highest VOC. So again, let's say you have to find a trade-off between, let's say, the VOC and the fill factor. Unfortunately, it's a relatively broad process window, and you can go have reach, let's say, VOCs of close to 700 millivolts at still, let's say, sufficiently high fill factors, well above 80%. This translates in the end also in solar cells or in optimum process windows for solar cells, I mean, which is seen here on this four pictures, where you can see that now bringing everything together, you can reach the highest efficiency still at the relatively high also sheet resistance and let's say medium firing temperature, where you then would expect, let's say, the highest efficiencies. In that case, it's at around 22.5%. But on the next slide, I can show you also, let's say, our current champion run, having exactly this type of process sequence, where you then even at least still could overcome the 700 millivolt barrier for VOC. So we are slightly above. And already also could reach the 23% efficiency for a really relatively lean industrial TOPCon solar cell process. I think that brings me already to the summary. I hope I could show you a bit more details about our industrial TOPCon process sequence. Implementing an PECVD deposition process for the polysilicon layers with, let's say, the benefits of the in situ doping, the high deposition rates, and the really excellent surface passivation quality. I hopefully also could show you that it is compatible with current screen printing technology if you find, let's say, an optimum process window and the trade-offs between, let's say, passivation quality and contact performance. And what still keeps us hope that we can, of course, even go further in efficiency is the fact that the industrial TOPCon cells nowadays are still relatively strongly limited by the recombination at the front side. So the boron emitter at the front side definitely, of course, will not be, let's say, the optimum for the future. And I think further research there is necessary to especially tackle this, let's say, largest part of loss, which is also depicted in the right diagram, where we did a loss analysis of the current industrial TOPCon cell. Yeah, thanks. And the best cell currently at ESA, we have reached also 23% with the processes I showed you. Thank you very much for your attention, and also all my colleagues at ESA who at least partly also here or within the conference. Thank you.
Thanks, Jochen, for this nice presentation. A few questions, I think we have some time. Just first, so some content related question. The results you showed were for float zone. Do you have also results for Tucholsky material?
Yeah, I mean, the solar cells were all done on Tucholsky solar cells. It was, of course, mainly the passivation performance, which was done on float zone. But I mean, all the rest is done on Tucholsky.
Okay. One question was here that your champion cell has bus. Does it have bus bars or is it bus bar? Is it a bus bar free cell?
That's a bus bar free cell. Yes, that's right.
Okay. Maybe you can also say something. I don't know if you have this information, but I think you work pretty close with Centrotherm. So what do you see on the market side at the moment regarding PECVD? Shravan already mentioned that that apparently there's also some trend away from LPCVD because of its wraparound limitations. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I mean, the wraparound, of course, is definitely also an issue in PECVD. I mean, it was already when you deposit in silicon nitride layer as anti-reflection coating, you had wraparound. So this is something, of course, which definitely also has to be thoroughly investigated in the new setups of PECVD systems, that you definitely avoid this in order to, in the end, of course, also avoid, sorry, Holger, for your next presentation, but to avoid, let's say, the single site, removal of this parasitic poly, which you do not want to have on the front side. Yeah. So it will definitely, in the end, I mean, to have a really lean process and also a cost effective process, you need that, you need really this single-sidedness.
Okay, there's also one question on design. I'm asking about your test samples, which are textured and the rear of the cell is planar. So do you expect to have lower J0 met in the cell that have 100 to 220 FA mentioned in your presentation?
Yeah, I mean, on an let's say real cell structure, usually you have, let's say, I mean, you are not really targeting, I think this is also something which would be definitely too expensive, that you are really have a polished rear surface. You are more or less living with the same surface you have in a PERC cell structure, which is, let's say, after the single site removal of your boron emitter, is a flattened pyramid structure. I mean, that's the same for TOPCon. And of course, that limits a little bit, let's say, your achievable passivation quality, but you are at anyhow very low values. And as already mentioned, the TOPCon cell in the moment, of course, is not necessarily limited by the rear side. It's much more limited by the front side.
Okay. I think then, I think the rest we can discuss during the panel later. So thanks again, Jochen, for your comprehensive overview. Okay, then let's continue to the company that was already mentioned a couple of times and is now for sure